Idleman Unplugged is part of the Edify podcast network.
I want to see your face pass me by the crowds of people, the priest who sing your praise.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Idleman Unplugged. I am your host, Luke Duncan. As Westside Christian Fellowship prepares for a season of fasting and prayer, Pastor Shane reads you the first chapter of his new book, 40 Days to Reset Your Life, Applying God's Wisdom for Physical and Spiritual Renewal. 40 Days to Reset Your Life is available in audio form on Audible, as well as Amazon Kindle, and free electronic or PDF formats at wcfav.org. We hope that you enjoy this segment of Idleman Unplugged.
A hunger and thirst for your righteousness, and it's only found one grace.
Part 1, Building the Foundation. Chapter 1, What is a Reset? During times of crisis, the power of prayer and fasting leads to wisdom, peace, protection, insight, and guidance. That is the thought for this chapter, so keep that in mind. The term reset has been thrown around a lot lately. Whether it's a global reset, financial reset, or a health reset, it's clear that we are intrigued with starting over. The definition of reset from a biblical standpoint is a spiritual renewal. It occurs when people turn back to God and experience Him in profound ways. Thank God for second, third, and fourth chances. Sadly, we often measure success by how much we have or what we do. But God looks at our spiritual condition via a broken and contrite heart, cross-reference Psalm 51:17. Seeking God through fasting, prayer, worship, humility, and obedience must be a priority if we are to experience a true spiritual reset. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They will mount up wings like eagles. They will run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Isaiah 40:31. Now, I'm concerned that many are fearful but not repentant, anxious but not surrender to God, worried but not worshipful, confused but not diligently seeking Him. What will it take to draw us back to God? We must change course. God hears the prayers of His people and desires to pour out His Spirit on a dry and thirsty land. Are you dry? Are you thirsty for more of God? Hunger for God leads to a spiritual reset. The power of prayer and fasting. During times of crisis, the power of prayer and fasting leads to wisdom, protection, insight, repentance, and guidance. Granted, we can't dismiss God's sovereignty by putting too much emphasis on our effort, but it's clear that spiritual disciplines with the right heart can usher in God's blessing, protection, guidance, and provision. For example, look at the cure for judgment that God gave the prophet Joel. Fasting was an important part of it. Consecrate a fast, call a sacred assembly, gather the elders and all the inhabitants of the land, basically get to church and cry out to God. The same call went out to the city of Nineveh in the book of Jonah. The same call goes out to us today. Fasting is also an important spiritual discipline. Jesus said, when you fast, not if you fast. Matthew 6:16. Therefore, my goal going forward is to help you incorporate the discipline of fasting into your life. Unbeknownst to most people, in addition to the health benefits of fasting, fasting is one of the greatest ways to remove destructive habits and transform your mind with the truth. Romans 12. When fasting, you're also encouraged to be very selective with your thought life and media choices. Instead, use the extra time to read and meditate on God's Word. Folks, this is vitally important. When we fast, when we give up certain things, and fasting in a biblical sense is giving up food, giving up any type of nutrients to the body, we have to exchange that with seeking God and not just sit around at home watching TV. There has to be an exchange that takes place. Gordon Cove rightly noted, when we overeat, we are too sluggish to pray, and hence we never come within the range of the Spirit where He can do great things for us and through us. I can definitely relate. Having a full stomach makes preaching difficult, prayer hard, and worship challenging. That's why the best time for me to pray, worship, and read the Word is early in the morning on an empty stomach. Fasting is a heart issue. On certain days, you may not feel like seeking God, but it's not about how you feel. It's about aligning your heart with God's. E. Stanley Jones noted it this way, or said it this way, if I throw out a boat hook from the boat and catch hold of the shore and pull, do I pull the shore to me or do I pull myself to the shore? Prayer is not pulling God to my will, but aligning my will to His will. Fasting is all about delayed gratification. The key is to keep moving forward despite feelings. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Hebrews 11:1. Genuine faith moves forward despite setbacks and trusts in God regardless of how we feel. But if you fall, immediately get back up and continue the journey. Fall forward, or as they say in business, fail forward. Get back up and fight again. For example, if you watch something that you shouldn't or cave in when fasting, repent and get back on track. Life is a marathon, not a sprint. I'm not offering a license to sin or to blow it. I'm offering grace to finish the journey. There are times when you may need even a reset to reset your reset. In other words, you've been trying to reset and get your life on track and something happens and you have to get back on track. So it's okay to reset your reset. For example, if you're doing well on a fast but succumb to temptation in a moment of weakness, simply start up again and reset. This humbling process works wonders when it comes to softening the heart. As Christians, we know that spiritual warfare is very real. The enemy attempts to derail us at every turn. He wants us to quit rather than to build the spiritual muscle of perseverance. Perseverance is strengthened in the furnace of affliction and in the midst of defeat. It means to stay the course despite difficulties, despite obstacles, and despite discouragement. When we continue down the road, even after crashing, we develop perseverance and fortitude. This is why I often encourage people to use failure as a stepping stone, not a stumbling block. I'm also not suggesting that fasting or fasting for a certain amount of time is the only way to succeed. God blesses a broken and contrite heart, not a work or a timetable. But fasting has been an important spiritual discipline throughout church history, as well as in both the Old and New Testaments. If God is leading you to fast, whether it's short-term or long-term, it's always best to listen and obey. He blesses choices that are focused on Him. This is an important part of the reset. Always remember that He blesses choices that are focused on Him. So if you're in the process right now of making choices that are not aligning with God's will, it's going to bring in a lot of confusion, a lot of anxiety, some fear. The key is to get back in the center of God's will, even if it requires making some hard choices. I'd rather fall forward into God's arms of forgiveness and restoration than continue in disobedience outside of His will. So if you decide to fast, read Isaiah 58 first. Isaiah 58 talks about the importance of having the right heart toward God and others when you fast. It's crucial to maintain thankfulness despite how you feel. There have been times when I entered a fast begrudgingly instead of with joy. I prayed, "Lord, I'm excited to spend this time with you during my fast," but I would complain during the first few difficult days. A changed heart changes habits. How bad do you want to reset your life? Will you turn to God with all your heart? Will you humble yourself and repent? It all begins here. We have become comfortable. All-night prayer meetings have been exchanged for all-night Netflix binges. Powerful worship services where the Spirit of God is moving have been turned into 60-minute programs designed to entertain rather than convict. And we are measuring success by likes and followers rather than by Christ-likeness and following Him. If you have any hope of a spiritual reset, it will begin with a revived heart, and that will come at a price. We must deny ourselves and fully surrender our lives to Christ. Cross-reference Matthew 16. Fasting is an important tool of surrender that meets the requirements of 2 Chronicles 7:14 as well. To humble ourselves and pray and seek God and turn from our sin, fasting in a sense breaks the prideful heart into pieces. Now, 2 Chronicles 7:14 obviously was applicable to the nation of Israel. Contextually, it was written to Solomon and what the people should do when God brings pestilence, when He brings famine, when He brings judgment, that they were to humble themselves and pray and seek His face and turn from their wicked ways. However, those principles still apply to us today. If we humble ourselves and pray and seek God with all of our heart and turn from our sin, you don't think He's going to answer that step of obedience? He absolutely will. So again, fasting breaks a prideful heart into pieces where God begins to rebuild those pieces and puts the puzzle back together. A changed heart changes habits. It all begins here.
If you've enjoyed this episode of Idleman Unplugged, be sure to check out the links in the description to get your copy of 40 Days to Reset Your Life Applying God's Wisdom for Physical and Spiritual Renewal. You can download the book for Kindle on Amazon or for free in PDF or electronic format at wcfav.org. Again, my name is Luke Duncan, and I am your host of Idleman Unplugged. Thank you for listening to us today, and join us again on the next episode.
Thank you for listening to Idleman Unplugged. For more information, visit us at ShaneIdleman.com. Again, that's ShaneIdleman.com.
This podcast is part of the Edify Podcast Network. Edify is a faith-inspiring app that brings together thousands of the best Christian podcasts in one place for your listening enjoyment. Cut through the noise and grow your faith by diving into the world's top Christian podcasts today. Download the Edify app for free from the App Store or Google Play, or by going to edify.app. That's edifi.app.
El Paseo Publications proudly supports the Westside Christian Fellowship Radio Network. We are committed to quality in Christian publication. Free ebooks can be found at westsidechristianfellowship.org under free ebooks. Books such as What Works for Men and What Works for Young Adults will help readers understand that the obstacles ahead are never greater than God's power to take you through. Books such as What Works When Diets Don't and Feasting and Fasting demonstrate how health can be achieved from a biblical perspective. Other free books such as Answers for a Confused Church and Desperate for More of God show the importance of fully surrendering our lives to Christ. And One Nation Above God is a must-read for anyone concerned about the direction of America. Again, free downloads of these ebooks are available at westsidechristianfellowship.org. We are happy about partnering with the Westside Christian Fellowship Radio Network.